everybody, and welcome back to Hatch 2.0. My name is Sue, and I am from OML Embroidery. And this is part two of the photo stitch. There are more than one way to do something in embroidery. There's always a workaround. It's always nice to know the options. So I brought in, this is Odie again, a different picture of Odie. This is what we're going to do here. So select it. And we're going to go to crop because we want to crop the picture. And you can go to curve. And when you go to curve, then you can left and right click and do any shape that you want. Sadly, Odie's ear is kind of cut off here. But if we wanted to kind of make it a cameo, you can do it this way. And I'm just left and right clicking, left and right clicking. So you have exactly what you want. Now when you're done, hit enter, and you have your picture cut out. Now obviously Odie is a little bit difficult to do that way. However, you can do quite a few different things with it. Why don't we grab one of those borders that I was talking about? So let's go to standard shapes. And let's go to the urban borders and see if one of these are going to work lovely for my Odie. And let's pick this one and just see, or a crest or a shield. Now, we're going to do this in a line. So we just want it to outline, and we're just going to pull it out like this and click, and we're done. And now we can move it around and see how it's going to work for my Odie. Let's pull it down just a little bit, and we're going to have some nice colors in there, and I think that's going to look great. So obviously that does not crop the picture, so this is kind of a workaround to be able to do it. Now we're going to click on curve, and all we have to do is basically trace this outline. Super easy to do, and it's just a different way of doing it. Now, my only problem with this is that I don't see how good it looks in stitches until we are done the photo part. So that's okay. I mean, either way it works. So let's just continue on. So you can do any shape with this. This is how it'll work. Any shape. And just take your time. I'm kind of rushing through it. This is like my third video of the day. So we're just using the border as an outline. So when you're done, click, and there we go. It does it. I hit enter, not click. And then we'll take off our shape that we used for a guideline, and we have cute as pie Odie. So let's go to auto digitize. And we are going to do color photo stitch, and it's going to come up. Make sure we have the right size. Look at my Odie. Isn't he cute? So again, here we are going to work on the, you know, thread numbers. See, I like that better. I just clicked it up to 8, and I like that much better. You can see Odie's eyes. Actually, 10 is as far as I'll go. I kind of like that. 9 or 10. You guys let me know in the comments which one you think is better. I think 9 or 8. I'm just looking at Odie's face. You know, that one's okay. I'm going to go with 9. I think that's even better. So I like that. That looks like my Odie. So let's apply that and let's go okay. And now you can see that we have a lovely picture of Odie. And it's going to be really easy to do. And look, there are a lot of pieces to my Odie, but that's okay. That's okay. I might have liked to pull this in a little bit. So basically, if you're doing it this way, it does work and it is faster. You can see that I didn't have to let my computer think about it. But I think this should come up a little bit more. Let's go back and undo color photo stitch and undo that and undo delete, so I have my lines back, and undo curve. So you can just undo it and do it again. So I think I would do it this way so we don't have quite as much green in the back. Yeah, I kind of like that. Then we can see Odie better. And let's do it again. So let's select the picture. Let's go to crop and let's go to curve. and then let's click on everything again. So either way, it's gonna take a couple times to get this right. So some people might think this is easier. Some people might not. So there's always more than one way to do something in embroidery. And this is just a second way of working with the photo stitch, which is amazing. It is amazing either way you do it. It depends if you want to see the photo stitch first and crop it, or if you want to crop the photograph. So either way it works, you will end up with the same thing. An amazing photo stitch design. So hit enter. We've cropped Mr. Odie there, and I am going to take our outline design and I am going to cut it so it's not there. And then we are gonna do click on it and we're gonna do color photo stitch and we're gonna bring up Odie again. It takes a minute, and 9, it kept the same setting. It's a little bit different now. I think, yes, I like that dark in there, lighter in there. So let's do apply. We've got 9 colors. Let's do okay. And let's paste down our outline that we had. And let's go to the outline. Let's make it satin and see how that looks. Yes, yes, that finishes it off just the same. I kind of like it. Or, you know, we can do a motif. There are so many motifs in here. Wow, you could play around with it and come up with something. That is really nice. I really like that. I'm going to adjust it though so it covers it over that part. So there's so many ways of doing it. I think either way, you can end up with beautiful pictures. And just to finish it off the same way that I did the first one, let's add his name. So Odie, a different picture of Odie. And I'm going to pick a font because I love doing that. That's one of my favorite things. How about a script for Odie? Let's make it a little bit bigger. See how pretty that is? I'm going to tuck that in the corner and I'm going to make that black. No, I think I want it a bit brighter. How about red? Odie wears a red collar. So we can make the outside red too. So two ways of doing the same thing. I think either way is fantastic. What a wonderful project. I can't wait to stitch this out. So thanks everyone for watching. I hope you guys like this video. Two ways to work with photo stitch. Either way, it is awesome. Thanks everyone for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.